गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। गुड
मॉर्निंग सर। गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग। गुड मॉर्निंग। गुड मॉर्निंग। व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट कंपोनेंट ऑफ द स्कूल बेस्ड मैनेजमेंट सो दैट वी कैन लिंक इट विद द स्कूल डेवलपमेंट प्लान। व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट कंपोनेंट और in very simple word you can tell that why we used to do the school based management, because we have a hierarchy of a management, as in the unit 1 we have already seen that the one hierarchy is at a national level, that is a ministry. Within the ministry we have a department, within the department we have a different structures of schools like Kendriya Vidyalaya, Navodaya Vidyalaya. They have a samiti for managing those school. Even the school at a government school at a state level, we have also a dedicated machinery for managing that. But why we have a school based management? Thoda fast reply karenge, then I will be able to come in the unit 4. Anybody can tell? Are you getting my question? Is it understandable? Pallavi is replying with to make institution more transparent. Maybe. Why you are telling maybe? You should be confident enough. Okay, Pallavi. Yes, you are right. More transparent. Okay.
सर, स्टूडेंट सेंटर्ड करने के लिए और मैनेजमेंट का वर्कलोड कम करने के लिए शायद ये हो सकता है।
स्टूडेंट सेंटर का यहाँ पे बहुत ज़्यादा रोल नहीं है, बिकॉज इट इज़ अ मैनेजमेंट पार्ट, इट इज़ नॉट अ टीचिंग लर्निंग प्रोसेस पार्ट। सो व्हेन वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग द टीचिंग लर्निंग प्रोसेस पार्ट, देन द स्टूडेंट सेंट्रिक एंड द लर्नर सेंट्रिक टाइप ऑफ अ कॉन्सेप्ट विल कम। ओके, to have, okay, so let me finish. To enhance the democratic setup, yes, I think Pallavi is replying more accurate one. Okay, Subhasri is saying that to have organized setup, but before without the having a school based management, we can have a organized setup also. It is not like that. So here is a basic 2-3 things why we used to have a school based management. The first thing is that there is a sociological educational sociological notion that those who are working with the system, they will be more informed about the problem, challenges and the opportunity within the system. Suppose that I am working in the UDT, so I am more aware that what are the hurdles are there, what are the challenges are there, how our students are there, and how we can work and how we can come out of that. Those who are from the outside may not be having the in-depth understanding of the issue, challenges and the opportunity. So it is necessary that to include the person who are working in the system. Other thing is that, okay, so by involving the different stakeholders, it becomes more transparent and the authority will be more accountable also. It is right, I am not denying that, it is right, and it is the also one of the reason why we should have a school based management. Because when you will see the theories that started emerging in the 18th century, those things have been kept in the mind, that to make them more accountable, to make the process more transparent. Okay, but when the person who are a part of a system, suppose that the parents, suppose that the teachers, supporting staffs, alumni, even the students, they are the part of a school system. सो इफ दे विल बी इन्वॉल्व देन दे विल बी मोर इन्फॉर्म्ड अबाउट द इशू एंड चैलेंजेस एंड अपॉर्चुनिटी दैट द एजुकेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट इज हैविंग. ओके एक्चुअली वेन वी स्टडी द डोमेन इट इज द डोमेन दैट इंस्टीट्यूशनल बेस्ड मैनेजमेंट बट हियर स्पेसिफिकली वी हैव मेड इट अ स्कूल बेस्ड मैनेजमेंट. Another thing is that when you will involve the stakeholder in the management process, they will have a feeling of a ownership. Okay, this belongs to me. And when they will start feeling that it belongs to me, so they will have a feeling of a caring and sharing for the betterment of the institutes. And the most important part of the school-based management is that which comes from again from the sociology of educational sociology, that the education and a educational system both is a unit of a society. Educational institute is not delinked from the society, it is a linked from the society. So the social participation should be there. And education that we want to impart through the institution, suppose that there is a school, so the focus of education in that school should reflect the need and necessity of the society, which will vary from society to society. We cannot have a one tailor-made approach to fulfill those need and to identify the need throughout the country. So these are the basic points. And since this philosophy says that a part of a school management should be at a school level only, because there is a hierarchy of a management, but a part of that must be at a school level to take care all those needs. And from there the concept of a school development plan comes, means how those stakeholder will come together for making a plan for the better and holistic development of the school structure, making it more accountable, more transparent. Isn't it? Because whatever the developmental plan we will have at a school level, that will be focused towards the specific need of the school. So now we will have a discussion over the school development. Yes, Shamya Mohapatra is replying that the proper utilization of a fund and money. Yes, it is also right, because when the fund and money will be coming to the school stakeholder, local stakeholders, they will be knowing that what are the priority. Suppose that I am sitting at a higher hierarchy level, I will be sending funds for making the school building. But the basic necessity at a school level is that the availability of a safe drinking water, hygienic toilets, it may be there, recreational areas, and that's why it should be okay. So that was all about the school management that I wanted to talk to link the unit. So from the discussion we have till now, somebody you tell that why we have a school developmental plan, or what is the function of a school development plan as per your conception? Anybody? आई एम सीइंग द फर्स्ट नेम अमिता रानी सिंह, आर यू हियर अमिता रानी सिंह? हाँ, सो कैन यू रिप्लाई अबाउट द क्वेश्चन दैट आई हैव रेज्ड? अच्छा, ओके ओके. सो आशुतोष पंडा, नेक्स्ट वन इज.
यस सर.
हाँ
सर, स्कूल डेवलपमेंट प्लान इज टू ऑर्गेनाइज द स्कूल.
ना, ऑर्गेनाइजिंग इज अ डिफरेंट थिंग. विद इन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन डेवलपमेंटल प्लान विल कम. ना, इट इज नॉट दैट मच अप्रोप्रिएट. ओके, सो वन मोर आई विल टेक. वन मोर रिस्पॉन्स किसको पूछेंगे? प्रियंका आचार्य, आई एम सीइंग वन नेम. यस प्रियंका, आर यू हियर?
यस सर. यस सर.
हाँ any response from your side? Okay, no response. So I will take the some of the response that has come in the chat box. To make school a better place for a student, strategic plan for improvement, okay, for school improvement, okay. No, so in school improvement and the strategic plan for improvement and all those things, making a better place, it is a very general idea. The school development plan includes overall planning regarding the curricular and a co-curricular event ongoing in this. Yes. Sir, if we do a planning, there must be a better result. Obviously, planning will always result a better result. Okay, if it is implemented in a desirable manner, well structured manner. For developmental plan, a betterment of a school and a student, obviously it is a for betterment to make a school function flexible and a successful. Okay, so first we will see that what are the different first we will see that the meaning. Okay, so when we talk about the plan is a structured blueprint to carry out any specific work, because in order to have a developmental plan, we must first talk about the plan. What is the plan? Plan is a structured blueprint to carry out any work. Like that, you have already done a lesson planning. That is a plan. What you were doing in the lesson plan? You were analyzing the different thing, the content, pedagogical approach, situation in the classroom, and you were planning that out of that situation in the classroom, out of the content that I am supposed to teach, out of what kind of a pedagogical approach and a structure should be planned to teach in a effective manner. So that was a plan. When we try to make a building, we have a blueprint. That is the sketch of the building to be built. Why we have a sketch? Because if we will have a sketch, blueprint or a plan, we will be able to better analyze that what is our requirement, for what purpose I am making a building, and in order to fulfill that, and what kind of a resources I have, that the land resources, money resources, and the manpower resources, like that. So out of that, what should be the structure that will fulfill my requirement within the premises. So plan is a blueprint for what? To carry out any वर्क, डिजायर्ड वर्क, इट इज अ ब्लूप्रिंट, इट इज अ स्ट्रक्चर्ड स्कीम, ओके, सो दैट इज अ प्लान. बट हियर द प्लान दैट आई विल बी वी विल बी टॉकिंग इज द स्ट्रक्चर्ड ब्लूप्रिंट सिस्टमैटिक अप्रोच फॉर द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ अ स्कूल. And obviously, when we will be talking about the development of a school, it will cover the scholastic curricular area, co-scholastic co-curricular area, societal link up, है ना? Because in order to function a school in a better manner, it must have a societal link up. Then curricular, co-curricular, we have covered, societal link up, then the management aspect, the smooth and efficient management, then the proper utilization of the resources, and the proper procurement of the resources. So here, when we talk about the school management, we mean that, school developmental plan, here we mean that a blueprint or a structure for the proper co-curricular and curricular activities, for the management of a different aspect of the school functioning, and as well as the linking school with the society. So that is the school developmental plan here. So how we will do? Then the next thing come that we have seen that what is the school development plan. It is a blueprint, it is a scheme, it is a structure. What will be the different component, that also we have seen. But why it is important? I have told you that the co-curricular, curricular management part, linking it to the society, making more transparent, more accountable, like that. These are the different component of the school development plan. But why it is require, why it is necessary? Then again the discussion here will link to the previous one. That's why I have given you the brief introduction about the school based management, because we know that a school is a miniature society. It is not a society itself, it is a miniature society where a student from a different groups are coming, different locality are coming, different caste, class, religion, cultural practices are coming, and each one of have a different priority area for them. Suppose that a student is coming to a school, suppose that for sake of example a secondary school. Why am I taking the example of a secondary school? Because here the student start planning for their future. They want to be, some of they want to be a IAS officer, some of they want to be a doctor, engineer, or like that. So now they start seeing a dream and they start planning for their career, future career. But everyone's priority may not be to become a doctor, to become a engineer, to become a IAS officer. It may be based upon the different variables. Okay, it may be based upon the different variables. But everyone's priority may not be the same. इवन द एवरी द प्रायोरिटी फॉर एवरी सोसाइटी मे नॉट बी ऑल्सो द सेम बेस्ड अपॉन द कल्चरल वेरिएशंस बेस्ड अपॉन द नॉर्म्स एंड बेस्ड अपॉन द सर्टेन अदर वेरिएबल्स सो देर इज अ नेसेसिटी टू इंक्लूड दोज थिंग्स एंड हैव अ ब्लू प्रिंट that will be at a local level. See, whenever we will talk about the school development plan, basically it is at a school level, that is a local level. However, the government and the ministry and the concerned department, like that, when we talk about the Orisha mass education and literacy department under the Ministry of Education, they also have a school developmental plan. Their motto is a different, that also I will be talking about. Even when we talk about the Ministry of Education at a central level, under that ministry we have a Department of School Education and Literacy. Again that we have a different committees for the development and the management of a school. They also used to make a school developmental plan. That all we will discuss in the next part of this discussion. The first part is that, so the school, every school have a specific need, and that's why they require a specific developmental plan as per the need and a requirement of that particular school. Every school may not have a same and a similar kind of a necessity of a developmental plan. So the school level developmental plan is basically decided by the locality and a focus of the school. Suppose that in a same locality, suppose that I am talking about the where I used to live, that is the Chandrasekharpur area. So in the Chandrasekharpur area, there is one DAV school, there is one Saraswati Vidya Mandir school, which is nearby my house, and there is a government school also, that is also nearby my house. So more or less, the student, those who will be coming to these three schools, for example, these three schools only I am taking. That is the one is the DAV, Saraswati Shishu Mandir, and that is one the government school, state government run school. So the student who are coming to that school, basically they will be from the same locality. But the children who is coming may not be from the same family and a cultural background. So even though the all these three schools are located at a same geographical location, but their school based development plan, that is the local developmental plan, will differ because the aspiration of the children, the priority area of the stakeholders, the students are different. Isn't it? And it is also based upon the philosophy of the school. The DAV person, they used to start the school process with the Vedic mantras and then some havan they used to do like that. As during my internship, not internship, I think during my multicultural work of my B.Ed. course, I was sent to the DAV school, and there I have observed for 1 week. So out of that input I am telling you. Okay, if someone's from the someone family, the some children are studying in the DAV or a DPS, you will be better able to know that what I am knowing, because it is my experience of a 1 week only. So their focus area will be different. So in order to cater those specific need, because the need is different, So in order to cater those specific need, the local school-based school-level developmental plan is very much required and needed. The second thing is comes that there is a some focus area from the state government or the central government, better to say that the government. They have some of the focus area for the particular type of a school. For sake of example, when we talk about the Orissa government, they have a different types of school within that. They have ashram schools, they have Adarsh Vidyalayas, they have other set of a government school. Three set of a government school here I am talking about. That is one of the ashram schools, that is a centrally sponsored scheme. One is the Adarsh Vidyalaya Samiti, Adarsh Vidyalaya, that is the state sponsored program schools. And there is another like that, we have a school in the unit 9 where you were attached. So they are also a state sponsored schools. But the objective and a focus area for these three schools is a different. The objective behind establishing a Adarsh Vidyalaya is a different. The objective behind establishing a ashram school is a different, and the other school is also a different. Even some of you were engaged in the university high school. The objective behind establishing a university high school is also different. When you will see the DM school of RI Bhuvaneswar, every RI have a DM school. So objective behind establishing a DM school is again a different. So to cater those specific need behind establishing those specific schools is a different, that's why government also used to make a different school development plan for the different type of a school. But there may be a common concern throughout the country or throughout the state that needs to be fulfilled like that. And sometimes it is a global mandate also, which I firmly believe that most of the shift that we used to see in the school level, it is due to the global mandate. So there is some global mandate, or there is some priority area at a central level, that is a country level. Like that, providing a inclusive infrastructure, accessible infrastructure, and that's why government has taken an initiative to make the accessible infrastructure in all educational institute. Here I am broadening the discussion, because this type of a scheme is for the university, college and all educational institutes also. So this is the one of the plan that they have. Suppose that to provide the infrastructure for the school, earlier means before the start of the SSA, the schools were lacking of the building. So to provide the school, that is the concrete structure for the school, we were and before that we were not having a blackboard in the school even. So we have run a mission, blackboard operation, blackboard, to provide at least the minimum infrastructure in the school, that is the blackboard minimum, because the student can sit in the floor and they can sit, but without the blackboard, even the when we talk about the teaching learning, because the blackboard is a one of the teaching learning material, So without the other teaching learning equipment, the teaching learning process may happen. Why I'm saying may happen? Because it may not happen as it is desired. But it may happen. But without the blackboard, how the classroom will go? The point of saying that I'm trying to highlight here is that every level in the school management have their own priority based upon the need, and they used to prepare a school development plan for the, and ultimate is what is the goal? Ultimate goal is to proper function the school in the proper manner, in a desired manner. That is the ultimate goal. I am providing the blackboard or building the infrastructure or whatever I am doing, that is ultimately for the benefit of the student, benefit of the school, and the proper functioning of the school. I think some of you have written here something. The school development plan provides a school with continuous improvement. Yes, it provides the improvement in the functioning, in the infrastructure, everything, in the functioning even, and in the resource level also. To make school function flexible and successful, obviously ultimate goal is that school or the institution should function as per the requirement, need, better to say that as per the mission and vision of the school, because every school may have a different mission and vision. Yes, so I think we should have a small question answer session here. So if you have any doubt or any question, you may ask now. Any question, any doubt up to here? Yes, please. Are you getting me? Sibani, are you here?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Sir, school development.
Acha, Sudakshina, yes, please. Haan, puchiye. What are... Someone was asking me then.
सर स्कूल डेवलपमेंट प्लान रे पेरेंट्स मन कर कौन ये रो
जी स्कूल डेवलपमेंट प्लान एंड
पेरेंट्स और स्टेक होल्डर का किसी भूमिका रो जी सर
हाँ obviously whoever the stakeholder in the school, they have a role in the school development plan. Obviously they have a role. Stakeholder, who will be the stakeholder? First stakeholder will be the representative of a teacher, staff, better to say the staff, representative of the student, representative of the alumni, representative of the parents, representative of the society. So representative of a society like that, the mukhiya or the ward member or the MLA, like that. Okay. So
yes, sir,
they have a role in the school development plan. Obviously they have. Yes, Sudakshina, you want to ask something?
Sir, मेरा सवाल ये है कि yes sir.
हाँ, please. I think
सर मेरा सवाल ये है कि school development plan में जितना भी program आ रहा है उसमें उसको yes sir.
आपका प्लान आ रहा है उसके बाद आई एम नॉट एबल टू गेट प्लान आ रहा है
सर उनको रिव्यू करने के लिए कुछ
ऐसा अच्छा उसके रिव्यू का मैकेनिज्म दैट यू आर आस्किंग रिव्यू मैकेनिज्म
सर उसको जी सर
हाँ इसके बाद और कोई सप्लीमेंट्री क्वेश्चन है आपका
यस सर रिव्यू मैकेनिज्म आई एम आस्किंग
हाँ सो दोज हु हैव अ पुअर इंटरनेट विद अ
रिव्यू मैकेनिज्म क्या है और उसका मतलब इतना करप्शन क्यों हो रहा है?
अच्छा ठीक है ठीक है ठीक है, मैं बताता हूँ. करप्शन एवरीवेयर इज अ करप्शन. ओके सो बिफोर दैट आई विल लाइक टू से दैट इफ एनीबॉडी इज विद द पुअर इंटरनेट कनेक्टिविटी एंड यू आर नॉट एबल टू आस्क इन द वॉइस मोड, यू कैन टाइप योर क्वेश्चन इन द चैट बिकॉज पुअर इंटरनेट कनेक्टिविटी मीन आई एम नॉट एबल टू कॉम्प्रहेंड. So, Sudakshina is more concerned about that in the school developmental plan. Is there any review mechanism who can review the progress of a work or a quality of a work like that? Okay. So, in one word, the answer is yes. There is a review mechanism and there is a machinery to review the functioning of a school even if it is a decentralized that we have a school management at a local level, at a school level, school based management. So the review mechanism is there for the local level review because ultimately the funds is coming from the government. So government will make the step to review, to investigate that whether the funds are whatever the allocated is well spent or not, or more general, since it is the central government or the government funded schools, so they will try to understand that whether it is a functioning in a well manner or not. Or even if it is a private school, so the management will be also concerned about the functioning of a school. So they used to make a different body for the assessment. If it is a private school, then the management will make a committee to assess that the fund utilization, proper functioning, proper linkage with the society, all those things, they will make a committee. Government at a local level also makes a committee with the help of a local governance, like a ward member, like a member of a Panchayati Raj institutions or a MLA, like that. They also used to make a local committee to see the functioning of a school. Otherwise, within the government, they have a vigilance committee also. One vigilance committee is to stop the corruption, that is the central vigilance committee. But there is again a vigilance committee within the management of a school. Suppose that the education department, that is the school education department, will have a vigilance committee. Higher education department will have a vigilance committee whose function is to see the proper functioning of a school, to see that the proper utilization of the resources. So they have a mechanism, machinery they have. The next question was that why there is so corruption. There may be variety of a reason, but what I believe that because we are corrupt, that is the main thing. Because who is constituting a system? We are constituting a system because you are taking a teacher training degree. So after some time you will be placed somewhere. In some government school, some private school, or somewhere you will be doing a job. So do your job with utmost honesty, then there will be no corruption. We are not doing a job with our utmost honesty, and that's why the point of a corruption is coming. However, we used to blame a government which is elected by us only. Hum bolte hain ये गवर्नमेंट करप्ट है. हु इलेक्टेड देम? वी. व्हेन द नेक्स्ट इलेक्शन विल कम, अगेन वी विल वोट देम, दे विल कम टू द पावर. सो वी डोंट वांट अ चेंज. सो दिस इज माय फिलॉसफी. सम ऑफ यू मे नॉट बी एग्री विथ मी आल्सो, बट द बेसिक रूट कॉज ऑफ अ करप्शन इज वी, है ना, हम लोग ही हैं. और कौन रहेगा करप्शन का रूट कॉज? हम अपना काम नहीं करते हैं. Okay, so now there is one question from Chitra. School development plan is not one man army. It comprises people from society only. Yes, obviously, it is not a one man army. And it is not the process doesn't involve one person. Okay, there may be some chairperson. There may be one person who is looking the all things. Like at a school level, we may think that the principal or a headmaster is responsible for looking all those things. But planning and implementing, it is not a matter of one person. Under the table, things corruption are still going on, government and even family. Yes, it is going on. Yes, it is going on. I do agree. We are responsible. We are not judicious. One example I will cite. People are complaining that during this pandemic, since schools and institutions are closed, so the fees should not be paid to the schools. Why fees will be not paid? They have their expenses. They have their staff. Where they will go? Suppose that a teacher, suppose that a sweeper whose family is dependent on that job. So what they will do? And what they will do? If they will die, then you will tell that the government is responsible. Government is not responsible. Sometimes we should also take the responsibility of the governance. At a government level, they are not capable of looking every person. But we are capable of looking our neighbors who are in need, who are suffering. Government cannot see. We can see. Government cannot send the police to everywhere. But we can be vigilant what is happening in and around our society. We must be vigilant. Okay, so we should not blame the government for all the silly things. Pallavi is asking, sir, what is the funding pattern for the school development plan? The funding pattern, when we talk about, then the majority of the funds are coming from the government. And within the government also, there is a different funding pattern for the different programs. Like that, when we talk about the SSA and RAMSA, the funding pattern in the some of the state is a 50-50, means 50 to state, 50 to central government. In the some of the state, it is a 40-60. In the northeastern state, it is a 10-90, means 10% will be borne by the state government, 90% will be borne by the central government. So that is the funding pattern of the SSA. When we talk about the funding pattern for the salary of the staff, it is totally funded by the state government if it is a state school. It is totally funded by the central government if it is a central school, central government school, like a Navodaya or KV or like that schools. Sometime government launches a scheme like the scholarship scheme. So sometime the scholarship scheme is launched by the state government. So the whole financial burden will be borne by the state government. But sometime some scholarship is a central government sponsored scheme. So that will be borne by the central government. So specifically, when you will talk about the funding pattern, in a nutshell, I can say that the majority of our funds comes from a government if it is a government school. However, there may be variation as per the scheme. If it is a private school, then the majority of a fund is coming from the managing society. And obviously, the managing society is getting money out of the student fees. So, the student fees is a major source of a funding. Sometime in the private school, they used to get a funding from different institutions also, who are the like-minded. Like when we talk about the KISS school, here is the Kalinga Institute of Social Science, KISS school. So they used to get some fund from the UNESCO, UNICEF, Tata Durabji Trust and so many other institutes. They used to get a matching fund, usko hum log bolte hain matching fund, because they are not a permanent source of a funding, they are matching fund. Okay, so that is the when we talk about the pattern, so it is a various pattern. Ek koi pattern nahi hai ki main bata do, but ek simple samajh lijiye. If it is a government school, majority of a fund will come from the government. If it is a private school, then the majority of the fund will come from the fees collected from the students. Okay, is there any question again? I think now we should stop the class because it is already 10:55. So now you may leave this session here, and those who are from a mathematics pedagogy, you join at 11 o'clock. This class will be open. You may be here also. Okay. So thank you for being with me. Have a nice day.